My name is Taylor Robinson. I'm a freshman at UK in the chemical engineering department. I grew up in southern Illinois in a town called Edwardsville, just outside of St. Louis, Missouri. My father was in the Marines, and my mom just was a businesswoman. On my mom's side, my two uncles are in the medical field, but not research per se. The one who's a physician's assistant, and the one who's an orthopedic doctor, and just my grandfather telling me stories about the experiences that they've had and being able to help others. Ever since I was five, I can remember wanting to be a doctor as my future career path. And then as I grew up and later into school and middle school and high school, I really started to like math and things like that and problem solving. Also, Neil deGrasse Tyson, I watched a lot of his videos, and that got me interested in just science and the answering questions and things like that. And so just where those two met, I found a lot of interest in. I'm here 2 days a week, and on one day I'll cut muscle samples and kind of image those on the microscope and make sure they look all right. And then the following day I will make the liquid for the stain and then kind of prepare that and then image them, take them out on the computer, and count the certain cells that my research pertains to, and then kind of analyze that the next week. It's a collaborative experience, and I learn a lot from it, just doing the things that I do in the lab, whether it's staining or cutting samples and getting ideas off of one another and kind of learning from everyone around me is a breathtaking and humbling experience, to say the least. Right now, I'm looking at satellite cells, also known as muscle stem cells, and we know that they're involved in muscle regeneration. What I'm looking at is how they're involved with running in your day-to-day activities in an active versus a dormant adolescent. And with the mice, we depleted the satellite cells in one strand, and in the other, we did not. And we found that the two mice ran for the same amount of time, but not the same distance. And so I'm looking on the cellular level how the structure of the cells compares to trying to see where those imbalances lie. I would say that the most exciting aspect is after I've collected all the data, seeing where everything connects and how what I'm doing in lab on a day-to-day basis can kind of come together to give me ideas of, you know, oh, well, we see that this certain thing in the like the extracellular matrix in the cell is overgrowing, and that's the reason that this is happening, and just seeing why things are happening and answering those questions is really exciting. The future of the science that I'm working on, I would definitely say that it's finding out the true role of the muscle stem cells and then figuring out as we age, the number of the stem cells naturally goes down and seeing what that really means to us on a day-to-day basis. Making that connection and connecting it to other diseases and, you know, just going about day-to-day life as we age, improving that. The UK is a great place to do science because it's very open-minded in a sense of everyone's input is valued, and it's motivated by the impact that we can have and the fact that we're, you know, right next to the hospital and everything, and it really puts the importance on the patients and how this can affect them, and also just the vast array of opportunities that there are in the sense of research and the different types of research that you can get involved in. Any advice to someone looking into science, I would say keep an open mind, just about try to think of, instead of a specific thing you want to tackle, a subject of something that interests you, because a lot of times, you know, everyone growing up who has interest in research says, oh, I'm going to find the cure for cancer, I'm going to be the next person to do that, but a lot of times, what's involved in scientific research, it's 99% grind and 1% shine, in the sense that 99% of the time you're doing more tedious things to get data, gathering data, and 1% is analyzing and making a discovery. And so you have to find that field to where you can still enjoy that 99%. Thank you.